गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज चैप्टर इज चैप्टर थर्ड ऑफ आर बुक एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल डिज़ाइन। दिस इज़ आवर फर्स्ट पार्ट। इन दिस होल चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू कवर अप सर्टन कॉन्सेप्ट्स, दैट इज़ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल डिज़ाइन, दैट इज़ डेमोक्रेटिक कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इन साउथ अफ्रीका। व्हाट यू मीन बाय अपार्टाइड, दैट वॉज इज कॉल्ड the struggle against the apartheid, a new constitution framing in South Africa. Then second topic is about the need of constitution, why there was a need of constitution. We are going to learn the main demand of the South Africa, but the need of constitution is almost similar. Basic rules for all constitutions, that is called a set of written rules, so definition of constitution. Third topic is going to be about the making of the Indian Constitution, how it was being made. The process of Constitution is called the path of Constitution, and we are going to learn about path of Constitution of India. The Constituent Assembly of India, the guiding values of Indian Constitutions, what are the main points, basic rules, that is called the preamble or the dream and the promise that the constitution provided to the Indians, that is called preamble. And last one, that is the institutional design, that means the framework of constitution. It was rigid, it is rigid and flexible both. So that comes under the institutional design of Indian constitution. So first topic that we are going to learn about the Constitution of Africa. So Democratic Constitution of Africa, why it came into being. So first thing we are going to learn about apartheid, where that was a system of racial discrimination which was unique in South Africa. So because of the struggle of freedom and South Africa, it became independent, got the constitution. The Nelson Mandela, who was the main driving force, not only he fought for the freedom but also tried to get the rights and equality between the blacks and the white people. He was sent to jail for treason. Treason means the offense of attempting to overthrow the government that is in the rule. Treason was tried by the, that means it was levied against Nelson Mandela by the white South African government. So apartheid was the name of a system of racial discrimination which was unique in South Africa. It was imposed or it was made by the white Europeans who were settling in South Africa on the black native Africans. During 17th and 18th century, the trading companies, when they came from Europe, they occupied South Africa with arms and forces, the manner in which they occupied India. But the difference was that a large number of whites, they settled in South Africa and they became the local ruler. And when those white settlers, they settled, the system of apartheid was started by them. They divided the people on the basis of the skin color. The native black people, they were about 3/4 of the population. Beside that, the whole society was divided into two classes, that is colored people and the migrant Indians also. So that was the division of the society on the basis of the skin. Now the discrimination that was made by the whites is called the policy of segregation. So the white rulers, they treated all non-whites as inferior. The apartheid system was started oppressing the blacks, that means they tried to oppress the blacks. The non-whites, they did not have the voting right. They were forbidden from living in the white area. Non-whites could work in white area only if they were having permit. Train, buses, public places like colleges, libraries, cinema halls, they were all separate for whites and black, and this whole policy is known as policy of segregation. Hope you understood this point. Now after the formation of the African National Congress, which was started in 1950s, the blacks, colored and Indians, they fought against the apartheid system, that is segregation method. They launched protest marches, strikes were being organized by them under the leadership of African National Congress. So African National Congress, it led the movements that were started by the various peoples in Africa. Many workers union, communist party and sensitive whites, all of them, they joined the ANC to oppose the apartheid. So apartheid was declared unjust and racist by several countries, but still the white racist government, it ruled Africa for a long period. So end of the policy, it ended on 26th April 1994, and a new democratic state of Republic of South Africa, it emerged. So when it emerged, the apartheid government, it came to an end, and it gave way for the formation of multiracial government. So the new government that was made, it was not totally made up of the black majority, but also they were having the members of whites. So the equality of races was started in South Africa after the making of the Republic of South Africa. As it was born, it became and it worked under the leadership of Nelson Mandela in the starting, who was in the prison in the year 1964, and he lived in that prison for 28 years on the Robben Island. Now the constitution, what do you mean by the constitution? Why the need and why Africa needed the constitution? So constitution of a country, as it is a set of written rules that are accepted by all the people living in a country. It also determines the relationship among the citizens and also among the people and the government. That means a constitution works in two ways: how we work as a citizens, our relationship among the citizens, and second is about people and the government. So those two way of working is being decided by the constitution. Now the need of the constitution, why there is a need of a constitution in any country? It is a basic requirement that it needs to safeguard the interest of the common people, whether they belong to majority or they belong to minority. So both the communities of majority and minority, particularly the minority, they need certain safeguard methods. So need of constitution is to safeguard the interest of the common people. Now basic need, why there was a need for constitution in Africa? So the whites, they agreed to the principle of majority and one person, one vote. They also agreed to accept some of the basic rights for the poor persons and the workers, because they were having money power. That means resources were in the hands of whites at that time when the ANC was being framed and when Republic of South Africa emerged in 1994. So beside that, the blacks, they accepted that, they agreed that majority rule, that is the rule of the blacks, would not be absolute, it would not be totally in their hands. They agreed that the majority would not take away the property of the white minority. So now the whites, they are in minority in population, because the number, the counting of the whites was less than the blacks. As I have told you earlier, that 3/4 of the population of South Africa is of black. So whites, they were having concern that when the blacks are going to be having the power, they are going to throw them away or they are going to snatch their property. So because of that, they were having the concern. And when the Republic was being framed, the main concern was that the black leaders, they appealed to the black, that is black citizens, to forgive the whites for the atrocities they have committed when they were in power. So they have to be convinced that whatever has happened in the past, they have to forgive it, because if they want to build a new South Africa, it should be based on equality of all races. So the ANC party, it ruled through the sorry the white part the working the government working white working that was existing in the previous years, they have made the process of oppression, that is the policy of racial segregation. And after, when the constitution is to be made, the struggle, the constitution, it was made by debates and discussion, and it took place for about 2 years. And only after that, these main acceptance points were being written in the constitution. The blacks, they agreed that the majority would not be absolute, and they would not take the property of the white minority. So when they agreed, and all those agreements, they were written in the constitution, only then they are able to live together. These rules, they are made up of constitution of South Africa that has to be obeyed by all. Now, this constitution that was written in South Africa, it has to cover up certain tasks. So the task was that it generates a degree of trust and coordination among the people. That was the main necessity for different kinds of people, those who were going to live together. So there is a difference that the whites, those who were in the minority, those who have oppressed the blacks, they were supposed to live in South Africa. They were not living south they were not leaving the South Africa after the making of independence in the year 1994. So it also specifies how the government will be constituted and who will have the power to make the decision. So exactly how the government will work, that is also written in the constitution. Who is going to have the power, the working of the parliament members, and all those things are also written in the constitution. It also lays down the limits to the power of the government and specifies the rights of the citizens. So they also expresses the aspirations of the people about creating of a good society. So normally all those tasks are a part of all the constitutions of the world, but the constitutions, wherever the countries are having their own constitution, it is not necessary that all the countries are working in a democratic manner, but all democratic countries, they surely have a written constitution. So USA, France, they adopted a constitution, and afterwards it became an essential practice that whenever a democracy is being set up in the world, whichever country was accepting a democratic working, it was having its own constitution. Now, making of Indian constitution. Now, the making of Indian constitution, it was also not an easy task. It was difficult, but it was not like South Africa. So the constitution was difficult because India is having a huge population and it is having a diversity. So diversity in the sense of religion, sense of language, in the sense of rulers. As the after independence, the Britishers, they have left Indian rulers to decide whether they want to merge with India or to be a part of Pakistan, or if they want to be independent. So that was the main basic problem, that the rulers were also there, provinces were there, and we also faced the partition. So when the partition was being made between India and Pakistan, it was also very difficult whether how the minority, that is on the basis of the religion, Muslims, they left country, but still they were, some of them were supposed to live in India also. So we have to cover up all those problems when we were making our constitution. So this constitution makers, they were anxious about the present and the future of the nation. So it was a very difficult process for constitution makers at that time. So the advantage, but it was we were having that we do not have to create a consensus that was about the democratic India should look like, because the consensus of creating Indian constitution, it has already evolved during our freedom struggle. We have already faced that problem. We have fought for the independence, and the differences that were regarding the views, the path that we were about to take, so the basic ideas that we, the constitution makers, have to adopt, that ideas were already being decided by the constitution makers. So the path of constitution we are going to study in our next slide. So in this slide we have studied about South Africa, the policy of racial segregation, that is called apartheid. You are going to write them in your notebook. Then the making of constitution in South Africa, why there is a need of constitution in a general way, and then a second question regarding the need of constitution in South Africa. So there are two questions about need of constitution. One, need of constitution is of general topic, and second one is regarding South Africa. And then last question is why making of Indian constitution was not an easy process. So these topics you have to cover up and to be done in your notebook.